Southern African results from Mozambique's general elections have now started trickling in. Former rebel movement Renamo's leader, Afonso Dhlakama, has established a substantial lead in the first general election results from Angonia district in the western province of Tete, while the country's ruling Frelimo Party and its presidential candidate, Filipe Nyusi, are narrowly leading in the Manica Province. Well, the fifth democratic polls held on Wednesday were declared peaceful, with just a few minor incidents reported in two provinces. Partial results are being made public by district electoral bodies. The widow of former President Nelson Mandela, Graca Machel, has described the elections as the most contested ever. The ruling Frelimo is expected to win both the presidential and parliamentary polls. Mweli Masilele is monitoring those polls for us in Mozambique, and we're live to him now in Maputo. Good afternoon, Mweli, and thank you for your time on the PM News Desk.
A very good afternoon to you and the viewers at home.
Mweli, how is the count progressing so far?
Voting day has come and gone. Now it's been the counting ever since the poll closed. But to tell us more about the elections here, how did the elections go? We've got a veteran journalist in Mozambique. He's from the Mozambique News Agency, Paul Fauvey. He's going just to give us some more information about the election. Mr. Fauvey, can you just tell us, what is your opinion about the elections?
My opinion about the elections? Well, mixed. I think a lot of the election was unfortunately characterized by incompetence on the part of the election bodies. You had extraordinary situations in the city of Beira, one of the largest cities in the country, where dozens and dozens of polling stations did not open 5, 6 or more hours after the official time of 7 o'clock. This is unforgivable in a major city where there should be no difficulty in getting the ballot boxes and all the other extra materials to the polling stations on time. This is entirely the fault of incompetent and heartless bureaucrats who are prepared to let elderly voters, disabled voters, pregnant women, women with young children wait in queues for hours after hours after hours. There were also some serious incidents caused by Renamo, the former rebel movement. There was a Renamo riot in the district of Sangano in Tete province, in which Renamo destroyed polling stations, destroyed ballot papers, clashed with the police. It may be necessary to rerun the election in those areas. But in most areas, the election was free of violence. In most areas, it could be described as free and fair and transparent. The count is slow, the procedures are slow, but the results are trickling in.
Now, the preliminary results have been released. What do you make of the current results?
Well, it's clear from the parallel count of results done by the main observer group here in Mozambique, the Electoral Observatory, it's clear that Frelimo has won. It's clear that the Frelimo presidential candidate, Filipe Nyusi, has about 60% of the vote, compared to 32% for Renamo leader Afonso Dhlakama. Now, 60% may sound very good, but in fact it's a setback for Frelimo, because in the last general elections in 2009, the Frelimo candidate, now current president Amanda Gabuza, got 75% of the vote. So the Frelimo vote has actually dropped substantially.
That is our veteran journalist here, based here in Mozambique, just giving us a brief analysis of how he views the election here. Back to you in studio.
The SABC's Mweli Masilela speaking to Paul Fau, a veteran journalist. He's telling us that results in the Mozambican parliamentary and presidential elections are now trickling in, and it's clear that Frelimo is well in the lead with about 60% of the vote. Well,